Has this ever happened to you? You're busy making your Google ads and you launch them and then you don't know where they are. You search for them, you can't find them, you check websites, you can't see them there either. You even check on YouTube and you can't find your YouTube ads. Well, I made this video just for you. I'm gonna be showing you how to find your Google ads and I'm gonna do it for search, display and YouTube ads as well. So don't worry, I've got your back. Let's go. Now, if you're brand new here, my job is to teach you every single thing I know about Google Ads and do it in a easy, relaxed way. So if you're interested in that, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button and also hit that bell button because I'm going to be dropping new Google Ads tutorials for you every single week. So what I want you to do is log into your Google Ads account and let's figure out exactly where these search ads are. All right, so I'm in my Google Ads dashboard, and the first thing that I want you to do is make sure that you have a layout that's similar to mine, and that just means you need to switch to expert mode. Also, you don't have to be intimidated by expert mode. It just means it's gonna show you every single graph and where all of your money is being spent. So it's actually quite a good thing. So if you don't know how to switch to expert mode, I'm gonna link a video in the description below, and you can just access that, watch it, and then come back to this video as well. But I'm gonna assume that you're in expert mode already. Now, once you're in this dashboard over here, the first thing we wanna check is that we have our search campaign selected. Once you see that you have your search campaign selected, I want you just to change the date range to about the last 14 days. And the next thing you're gonna do is make sure that you actually have impressions on your ad. So when you click here, you'll just get a drop down and you'll select impression. So this is a good thing. If you see that you are getting a lot of impressions, this means your ad is showing. So as you can see here, my ad has been shown 272 times. So whenever somebody searched for my ad, I've popped up. You can also see the amount of clicks. Note that every time someone sees your ad, which is an impression, they don't always click. So your clicks is how many people have actually taken action and how many people have actually clicked on your ad. So don't get confused between the two. So the fact that I have impressions on this campaign is already a good sign, which means my search ad is showing. The next thing we can check is if you go down to, I think it's keywords and search terms, okay? You are going to see the terms that people searched. Hold on one second. We're in search keywords, sorry, search terms. When you go into search terms over here, you're gonna see what they actually searched and how many times your ad has popped up. So here somebody searched Google Skill Shop and my ad popped up 51 times and I got 7 clicks off of that and I also got some conversions from that as well. And you can see every single search that somebody searched and where you showed up in the search. Now, the next thing I want to show you is something quite cool. It's called Google Ads Preview Tool, okay? So when you go to Tools and Setting, once again, you need to be in expert mode to access all of this cool stuff. Ad Preview and Diagnosis. When you do this, it's gonna basically load a window for you and it's gonna show you what the search results are at the current moment. So if I type in Google Skill Shop, let's just see. This is just for example, Google Skill Shop, there we go. As you can see, these are my search results. I get this big warning in red saying my ad is not showing. And if I go on the preview result, it'll show me a preview of what is showing on the top of the search results. And I usually like to go for desktop at the moment. So it'll show you a preview. However, I do not like to use this tool because Google will always try and upsell you and they'll always tell you that you need to spend more money. Your ads are not showing enough. It's just how they get the maximum amount of money from you. And sometimes it really doesn't benefit you to increase your budget. So here's what I suggest you do. Go to anonymous. Watch, I'm gonna forget how to spell anonymous right now. Anonymous ad preview tool, Google Ads. Once you do that, Google Ads actually has one whereby it's not connected to an account at all. So when you do that, I'm in Boksburg, South Africa. Let's just make this South Africa.
Okay, leave it South Africa, and I'm just gonna search for something that we can find, like Adidas shoes. Once you do that, let's go for desktop. As you can see, everything with the word AD in bold next to it, that's a Google ad. So I've got one over here. Let's try something more, something that's closely related to the people who might be watching this right now. Or let's go emergency locksmith. Or actually, let's just go locksmith. Locksmith. There we go. So as you can see, that's a Google ad over here. And you get to see if your ad is coming up when you search. So the next logical question would be, Devin, what if I use the Google Ads keyword ad preview tool and I use the anonymous ad preview tool and I can't see my ad? Well, like I said before, if you do have impressions, your ad is definitely showing. If you don't have impressions, you might be running into a problem, and let's discuss some of the problems that you might have if your ad is not showing up or if you have almost zero impressions. Now, if your ad is exact match, your ad is not gonna come up, and how you tell it's exact match is you just go to keywords and search keywords, and then you can see if your keyword type is a broad or if it's exact. Usually for it to be an exact match, somebody has to type in the exact same words and have no extra words when they're searching Google. So for example, this one over here, somebody would have to type in AdWords course for my ad to show up. If somebody typed in, I need an AdWords course or best AdWords course, this ad would not show at all. However, if it was a broad match term and we had AdWords course, then it would show up because broad match kind of broadly matches your keyword to things that are related to it. So somebody could even type, I need training by Google, and Google Skill Shop will still show up as a result, even though it's not even in the search term, technically speaking, your ad will still show. So if it's broad match, you will get a lot more impressions than if it's exact match. If it's exact match, you're very specific about what they type into the search engine, and therefore it's not going to show up as much. Another thing that could impact it as well would just be your bidding strategy. Now, bidding strategy is just how much you are willing to pay for a particular keyword or to show up on a particular search. Remember, to get to the top of this list, to get to the top of the search results, you kind of need to have the best quality score and you need to pay the highest cost per click, in my experience of doing this for the past 6 years. So if you have a manual cost per click setup, like I've got a limit here that I'm only willing to pay about $1 per click. Obviously, some of these auctions, some of these times when somebody searches for my keywords, I'm not going to show up. And I'm perfectly fine with that because I don't want expensive clicks. However, if you want to show up on more, then I suggest you go to settings. After going to settings, I want you to go to bidding. And after bidding, change your bidding strategy. And then what you want to do is, let's just do this. What you want to do is either go for maximize conversions. This will get you expensive clicks, but you might not show up a lot more. The best one to go for would actually be maximize clicks, because this will get you into a lot of auctions and it'll try and get you as many clicks as possible for your budget, which requires your ad to be shown even more. Maximize conversions, it will take your ad, and if it thinks that it's likely that there will be a conversion, it'll take your ad and put it at the top of the search results, but it won't always put your ad at the top of the search results. So if you just purely want to go for being seen more, you're much better off going for maximize clicks. The last thing I want you to pay attention to is your, let's just go back. Yes. Leave me alone. Okay. So the next thing I just want you to pay attention to is your date range. Make sure that your date range is actually not only for today, because a lot of people make this mistake where they only make their ad show for that specific day. You want to make sure that it's showing over the past 7 days or the past 14 days or however long you've been running your campaign. And the last thing we need to talk about is also your search volume. Now, check this out. If Google Skill Shop only gets searched once in the whole of South Africa, if it only gets searched once per month in the whole of South Africa, I've only got one chance of showing up for this. So my ad is not going to get shown that often. So what you want to do is you also want to check the search volumes on your keyword and make sure that you got enough search volume in a particular area so that you know that your ad has a good chance of showing up. And the way you can check that is by going to Tools and Settings and looking for Google Keyword Planner. Now, I can do an in-depth video about Google Keyword Planner. I want you to comment in the section below and just say, I want to see a Keyword Planner video, and I'll gladly make one for you guys. But Keyword Planner actually gives you the search volume, and it tells you how many people are searching for a specific keyword in a specific month. So those are some of the ways you can check if your search ads are showing. Okay, so the next thing we're gonna talk about is your display ads, okay? So I'm gonna go to all campaigns, select display ads, okay? Now, as you can see, first and foremost, we need to go and just look at our impressions, exactly the same as the search ads. And as you can see, my display ads have been shown 1,690 times. So I already know that my display ads are showing. But the question is, Devin, where exactly are those ads showing? So to figure this out, first, make sure you have your campaign selected. When you have your campaign selected, I want you to go over to content, and I want you to go over, you'll see there's a thing here that says where ads showed. And when you click on that, sometimes you'll see there's like nothing here and just a button that says see where ads showed. That's just because Google is trying to kind of hide this information away from you. So as you can see over here, these are where all my ads showed. And I think what I want to do over here is, let's just do an all time. This is a fairly new campaign. There we go. So as you can see, my ads are showing YouTube.com, this YouTube channel. And yes, your display ads, your banner ads can show on YouTube channels as well. And you'll see that most of them are actually showing up on a lot of mobile applications as well. Let's see. Well, obviously not here because I've been doing some work on this campaign, but I think we've got a mobile application as well. In your specific case, when you go here, you'll see a ton of mobile applications. Now, mobile applications are not really that good because yes, they get you a lot of clicks, but those clicks usually come from either people playing games or, 5-year-olds with their parents' iPhones just playing a mobile game, and then your ad comes up and then they click on it accidentally. You're gonna get a lot of useless traffic from mobile apps. So this is where you see where your ad showed. And what you can also do is you can exclude certain places. Like, for example, if I don't want to show up on this dude's YouTube channel, I can just go here and I can tell it to exclude from my campaign or exclude it from my ad group as well. And what you can also do is build a master exclusion list if you go over to Tools and Settings as well, and that'll apply to your whole campaign. So if you find mobile apps or websites that are not in line with your brand or in line with what you're selling, all you have to do is just exclude them from your campaign and your ads will never ever show there again. So this is a cool way to see where your banner ads are showing. Obviously, you want to keep them showing on places that are giving you good conversions and also are giving you very cheap clicks. You do not want to show on places that are just getting a ton of clicks, but nothing ever happens to the traffic that comes from those apps or those websites as well. And you must remember something, the display network is huge, guys. It's like 200 million websites. So technically speaking, you'll never run out of places to show your ad. But if you feel like you're not getting enough impressions and you want to get more impressions on your ads, then the best thing that you can do is just simply increase your budget. When you increase your budget, you'll show up on more websites and therefore you'll have more opportunities to get more customers.
Now, if you have any more questions, I want you to post them below in the comment section. And yes, I'll be there to answer them personally, and I'll give you some feedback if you need feedback. All right, so we've done search, we've done display. Let's get into YouTube ads.
All right, so the last one that we want to look at is your YouTube ads or your video ads. All right, now, when I say YouTube ads, back in the days, they only used to appear on YouTube. They only used to show up on YouTube. But now Google Ads has released this new responsive YouTube ads, which means your YouTube ads could be showing anywhere. Although they are called video ads or YouTube ads, they could be showing up on mobile apps, they can be showing up on websites. So how do we actually check where they are showing up and if they're showing up at all? First thing you want to do is go to your impressions. Once again, make sure that you are seeing impressions. Next thing that you want to do is you want to make sure that you're actually getting some views. So what's the difference between impressions and views? Impressions could be if somebody's just seen the ad, but you know that little skip before 5 second button. If they push that button, then technically speaking, they haven't viewed your ad. Ads are for, I believe it's 30 seconds or more. That's where it counts as a view. And this would be your cost per view, okay? So I know that my ad is showing up over here. Next thing I want to see is where my ad is showing up. What YouTube channels, what YouTube videos, and also what websites or mobile apps if that information is available. So you want to go all the way down to, let's see, that's done. Oh, it's because I've got none of them that are actually running in this account at the moment. Okay, let's do this dude here, I think. Okay, let's go here. Okay, this one has a couple, so we'll use it. You're going to go to content, where ad showed, and exactly like before, it'll show you where your ad showed, but obviously this would be your video ad. So as you can see, I showed up on this YouTube channel, this YouTube channel, this YouTube channel over here. You can also organize them by type. So if you showed on a particular YouTube video, I think I have one where it shows my YouTube video, but anyway, you get the point. If it shows up on YouTube videos, it will show it here as well. And it will also show your ads on websites and mobile apps. And you can see most of the data here, but sometimes you'll see something strange, which is all of these add up, okay? Like all of these will add up to 62. But then sometimes you'll see this column that says other, and you'll see that this column that says other is also spending money as well. Now, when it says other over here, Google Ads doesn't actually tell you where it's spending your money. And it's extremely frustrating, especially when I'm with clients or when I'm coaching someone and we're trying to understand where the money is being spent. But you should be aware that in this other column, there are also other places where they will show your ads, but they won't tell you where your ads are showing. So don't get mad at me. Take that up with Google. But yeah, I should just let you know that as well. So if you have impressions and you go over to where ads showed, you will see where everything is. You'll get a better understanding of where all of your ads are placed, and you'll see if those are in line with your brand or your product or your service, and you can go from there. And just like before, if you don't like any of these places where your ads being shown, you can always exclude them from campaigns. Now, if you want to get your ads shown more, you can always increase your budget. There's not much that you can do with YouTube ads, but I would suggest that with bidding settings, you start off with maximized conversions, try and get your ad spending your entire daily budget, and then after that, switch over to target CPA, which is more restricted, and that's also going to give you limited impressions because target CPA kind of picks a target and tries to hit that target with the machine learning. But just for starters, just never mind all of this technical mumbo jumbo. If you just want to see where your ads are, this is all you need. Just go over to where ads showed and you'll see exactly where all your ads are.
Now, if you enjoyed this video, I want you to also check out my masterclass on how to make your Google ads more profitable. It's in the link in the description below, and I'm going to be teaching you 3 counterintuitive ways to basically boost your profit with your Google ads. So make sure you don't miss out on that. So thank you very much for watching. Please make sure that you like, subscribe this video, and also, special treat for you, I've got a Google Ads playlist here for beginners, so you can just watch one playlist and you can learn everything you need to know about Google Ads. How cool is that? Anyway, guys, I'll see you next time. Peace.